This program is rated PG. It contains themes and scenes which may not be suitable for very young audiences. Parental guidance is advised.
Be advised that the views and opinions of the hosts and guests do not reflect those of the station.
Katatapos lang po ng APEC summit sa Beijing and we saw the many countries involved in the Asia Pacific, 21 countries. The debate goes on about the FTAAP, Free Trade Association of Asia and the Pacific versus the TPP and so on. There's so many issues about trade and economics. Of course, we're facing the ASEAN integration too, you know, in this 2015. And amidst all these, there are members of our national intelligentsia who are forging ties with different countries to keep us, so to speak, ahead of the curve in this development of trade ties. Ang ating panauhin ngayon ay kagagaling lang po ng Vietnam. And they are here to discuss with us what they saw as potentials and possibilities of expanding trade between the Philippines and Vietnam. With very little introduction necessary, of course, Senator Eddie Ilarde, who has been our regular guest for the past years on this program, but he is also in this program, in this discussion, wearing the hat of the president of the Philippine-Vietnam Friendship Association. And later on, we'll discuss some of the unique roles that Senator Ilarde has played in our history in relation to Vietnam. And the chairman of the Philippine-Vietnam Friendship Society or Association, Dr. Gonzalo M. Jurado, who has been in very many roles also in his life, both in the Philippines and internationally. He is a retired professor of economics from the University of the Philippines, lecturer and consultant of ADB, I understand, and of course lecturer with the UN Statistical Institute for Asia and the Pacific. Consultant of the UNESCO for Asia. Is that UNESCO?
No. The UN.
United Nations Economic and Social Commission for
Asia.
I assumed it was UNESCO for Asia.
No.
Okay. And of the Development Bank in Manila?
The ADB, Asian Development Bank.
Nawala yung Asian dito. Okay. So we have two eminent Filipinos with us to report to us first their visit to Vietnam. How many days was that? Whom did you visit? Whom did you see? And we'll flash some of the pictures later on as evidence of the hard work of the two gentlemen here. So we start with the chairman, of course, you know, then the president. Chairman Gonzalo Jurado, ano ang nagsimula po nitong Philippine-Vietnam Society Association? How did it start? Is this new?
Conceptually luma, but as an organization, bagong-bago. Mm-hmm. All right. Magkakaibigan kami, mm-hmm. yung core noon, mm-hmm. we get together very often. And
on the Philippine side?
Yes, pure Filipino. Mm-hmm. And discussion, siyempre, covering the whole world sometimes. Mm-hmm. Each one expressing it. Dumating sa punto na, siguro, let's pay attention to Vietnam. Mm-hmm. On a people-to-people basis. Mm-hmm. Na walang politika, kultura ito. Mga kasaysayan, history, exploring possibilities. And the idea caught on. Mm-hmm. And then Eddie, who will later be elected our president, mm-hmm. was the leader in stimulating debate on these things.
Well, I think KAED has been a leader on the issues relative to Vietnam-Philippine relations from the 1960s. We'll get to the president of the association in a while. But let me ask you as an economist, what did you see in Vietnam in comparison to the Philippines?
All right. Dalawang bagay, no? Tinitingnan ko yung physical side of it. Na lumabas kami sa Hanoi, punta kami sa Halong Bay.
Oh,
I have to tell you, I was impressed.
Nine Dragon Bay yun.
I was impressed with everything that I saw. Their activity in extending their road system. And the designs are rather modern, huh? Yun ang nakita ko, the architecture.
Is there a difference between them and the Philippines today that you saw?
There is. Mm-hmm. Sa kanila, ang tingin ko, hindi lamang yung solidity ng hardware, kundi the artistic side of it. Mm-hmm. Yung kanilang arches, pabilog. Mm-hmm. Yung sa atin, mga standard eh. Mm-hmm. Parang dinampot mo yun sa kahon, okay lang yan. Alright. Second, ang pagbibuild nila ng roads, clearly with an anticipation of the future.
Nalalapad.
Malalapad. Lalo na itong Halong Bay nito. You would think at this time that they're a waste of space. No. Because in 5-6 years, I can imagine that place attracting a tremendous number of people and businessmen. So talagang impressed ako on the physical side. And then naturally, I was also observing the way our counterparts were behaving in some fashion. Nakita ko, they were all serious-minded. Kung anong pinag-usapan, talagang nakadikit dito. Bago magsalita, iniisip muna. I was impressed. Recalling, you know, our little history na dati-dati, para sa akin, ganyan din ang mga opisyalis natin. Ako, personal kong kinalulungkot na tila wala na yata yon. Ngayon, puro politika. Yun ang napansin.
I've been to Vietnam, I think, thrice. The latest was sometime in 97, 98 as a journalist joining the, representing the National Union of Journalists of the Philippines, and we went to Hanoi. We also went around Halong Bay, but one of the things we saw there while we were traveling was they were starting to plant alongside all the highways, mga puno. I wonder if that was noticeable in your trip.
Definitely, nandun dun. Ganda. It's a part of their looking forward. Nobody was using the jargon of environment at that time. Pero nandun na yung mga trees ngayon, medyo nagmamature na. So hindi barren ang kanilang cityscape.
Just to pursue that point, for example, you travel north or south expressway natin?
Both. I'm familiar with both. Yeah.
Compared to their highway?
As highways, where the trucks, the cars run, pareho rin. All right. So the engineering part to be
universal
yan. All right. Ang space natin nandiyan. Yun nga ang nakita ko. Kasi ang association ng socialist mentality is hardly one with aesthetics. Nakita ko yun, sabi ko, nagulat ako. Kasi lalo na familiarity with Russian socialist talagang eskwala. Ano yan?
Eskwalado.
Walang consideration sa aesthetics, masyadong pragmatic.
I was wondering whether you would mention na yung mga highways talaga, napakaraming halaman sa gilid. Kung may difference between our North and South Expressway. Parang dito mas sparse ang mga puno. Doon, noong kami bumabiyahe doon, that was very noticeable.
Ganun pa rin na yun.
One point about the... that's why I stress economics. That is socialist economics nga versus what we can see here. Do you have any impressions between the two?
The audience will pardon me, but I have been to Vietnam 2-3 times as a consultant on national accounts. Kasi socialista sila, komunista eh. Gumawa sila ng decision in the late 90s, nalilipat na sila sa atin, sa GDP. And I was assigned by the UN to go there and advise their government. And I did so, I had to travel twice. So tinuruan ko yung kanilang statistical system, you know. And para ako nagtuturo sa university.
Yeah.
Concepts, etc. Ano ba yung statistics corresponding to that concept. And what is the point of all this? Kailangan ito useful for looking forward, for planning, not just for the intellectual exercise of it. So, medyo familiar ako doon. Nung panahon yon, sabi ko nga, nag-i-istorya kami ni Edith, saka ni Louis, who is not here. Vietnam was nothing. It was all paddies, fields.
That's right.
All right. Ang Hanoi na yon, of course, it always had been laid back. Even more laid back, it was at that time. Parang isa, dalawang hotel lamang ang pwede mong tarhan. Okay, ay,
ngayon,
ay nakong dami. Okay. All right. So noon, very carefully sila na ilalagay ka rin sa pinakamaayos na hotel para magkaroon naman ng good impression. All right. But their best hotel, siyempre, I just kept quiet. They'll be the equivalent of our, well, sabi mo nang,
ito yun, noon yun.
Oo. Oh, oh. In the late 90s.
Mga 90s pa, yes.
Yeah. So mga, sabi mo nang 20 years ago. All right. Talagang their best will be our mga 2-3 stars.
Okay. So now things has changed tremendously.
They have changed a lot. Okay.
Well, we'll get back to the economics, no?
Yeah.
But let me explain why the special interest of Senator Ilarde in Vietnam. In the debates on whether to send contingent to Vietnam during Marcos's time.
Combat
versus other kinds of detachment from the Philippine Armed Forces to participate in the international effort for South Vietnam. Senator Ilarde fought against the idea of sending combat troops, military. And the Vietnamese really appreciate that. Let's get back a bit to that, the history, Ka Eddie, and then move forward to this establishment of the Friendship Association. We're going to take a break in 2-3 minutes, and then we'll continue after that. Si Tolimo, ano?
Well, first comment on, again, thank you for this opportunity of guesting in your program. And I'm very happy to know that your audience has expanded tremendously because you can be seen in the internet. And I receive some text messages from abroad telling me that I saw you in Kamentong's program. Itong aming pagpunta sa Vietnam, mga kaibigan, ay isang bagay na hindi pa yata naisip ng gobyerno na kinakailangan in the context of the present geopolitical crisis all over the world. Kinakailangan ang ating bansa ay lalong pag-ibayuhin ang paghanga at pakikipagkaibigan sa mga kapitbansa natin. Ako hindi pa napunta sa Vietnam, but I know the history of Vietnam from the perspective of the Trong sisters many centuries ago. They have been under French domination, colonialism, for several centuries.
They were a part of China until the 900s AD.
Yes, that's why I say China and Vietnam should not quarrel. Because they are brothers in blood and everything.
Pero minsan yung magkakapatid ang matindi mag-away.
Anyway, nabanggit mo yung combat team na ipadadala ng gobyerno natin noong panahon ng digmaan, noong kung ilang daang libong toneladang bomba ang ibinagsak sa Vietnam, kung ilang daang libong tao ang pinatay ng mga bomba ng Amerika.
Hanggang ngayon, Agent Orange, balubaloktot pa yung mga sanggol na
Agent Orange was supposed to be experimented in Los Baños. I was the one who exposed that in the floors of the Congress. But that's another story coming to.
That's very another show. We should discuss that. No?
Yes. Now, pinag-aralan ko ang history ng Vietnam at nag-uusap kami ni Gon at saka nung aming mga kasama na siguro kailangan nang magkaroon ng itinanong nga nung isang kasama namin, hindi ba niya meron ng Friendship Association?
Yeah, pero in-skip mo yung part na inopos mo yung combat troops and anong pinadala ng Pilipinas?
Nung malaman ko yon, I also stood again on the floor
anong
of Congress.
Year yan?
This is 1966.
66, okay.
And hit away at the folly of being in a war that is not ours. And I criticized Marcos tremendously, as I was criticizing Marcos many times. And I said that we should not send any combat troops to Vietnam because that is not our war. And, you know, in fairness to Marcos, I got a call from him. And he said that, Congressman, if it is any consolation to you and your fellow communists, of course he was kidding, no? Because I don't like some policies with America, doesn't mean that I'm a communist. I'm not a communist.
We're going to take our break para mabuo natin after this break itong kwento ni Ka Eddie. Okay, let's take this break.